Hey everybody, it's Matt again with Gone in Gears, and as you know, updates like on my leg and stuff. Foot surgery went well, everything's doing good with that, and I'm not getting nothing done on the car, but I wanted to come down just to switch it up so it looks like we still have a car here to work on. Stace also is doing better. They're running some more tests and stuff, and they upped her medication, and so she's doing better in that area also with her heart, so we're thankful for all the prayers for that. But so today I'm going to tie in also last week's. So we were talking about prayer and why prayer is getting answered. And this week also I'm going to be in James 4:4, and it says, "Ye adulterers and adulteresses, know ye not that friendship of the world is enmity with God? Whosoever therefore will be a friend of the world is the enemy of God." And so whenever we want the satisfaction of our own desires above everything else, we commit idolatry and we start worshiping other things other than God, and worldliness and godliness, that can't coexist. They don't go together. And so whenever Israel, they strayed after other gods also, the Lord accused them of adultery because, you know, Israel was the Lord's husband. In Jeremiah 3, that would be a reference there. So it's not a surprise here that James is calling the church members adulterers and adulteresses because of the adulterous people. You know, the church is the bride of Christ. That's in Ephesians 5, 22-33, and it talks about the church being the bride of Christ. And so friendship with the world, it's hostility towards God. And if we're messing around the world and we're pursuing worldly desires, you know, we're making ourselves the enemy of God. And whenever we put ourselves in that position, we can't expect God to answer prayers because we are asking amiss. And that's kind of what I was tying in last week. So we have to keep those things in mind when we're praying and asking for prayers. Our desires, make sure our desires and motives are the right thing, and make sure that we're seeking God for the right things. We don't want to be committing idolatry and putting worldly things before God doesn't want that. He wants to be first all the time. So go ahead and have a word of prayer. Lord, thank you for this day and your blessings, Lord. We're feeling the heat today out here. It's about 90 some degrees, and I guess that's better than snow, but we're thankful for that. And Lord, we're thankful for your word and all the answered prayers, Lord, that you give us. And this example, Lord, with James, it's just more proof, Lord. And it's you tell us, you know, you want to be first, and we can't be friends of the world and also friends with you, Lord. So just help us to resonate in our hearts, Lord. Help us to keep focused on you and everything that we do. In Jesus' name we do pray, amen. So yeah, I just wanted to come down here to, you know, show everybody that the car is still down here. Maybe in a couple weeks I might work on this quarter panel and get this done if I can stand here long enough to do it, because I can't crawl around in the car, obviously. But we'll just see what happens. We're trucking along. And I just want to thank everybody for watching the videos. I thank all the subscribers, all the viewers. I thank Stace, of course, for doing the video. She's always doing a good job. And just keep focused on Jesus. I hope everybody also is just checking out the shorts that I've been putting out. Just one verses, just for encouragement and, you know, telling who God is. Next week will be a little bit different on the shorts that I do for that. So stay tuned for that. Have a good weekend. We'll see you next week.